Coming in at just over 6 inches or 15 centimetres, this is G.I. Joe Edward Torpedo Lealoha. I've probably murdered the pronunciation of that, but he's normally known to the majority of us as G.I. Joe Torpedo. This figure first came out in 1983, so it's been some time, the original release right up to this one, and quite a difference in the figure. For one, we're getting a beginning and an end name on the packaging, and two, it's obviously G.I. Joe classified. It's incredibly detailed, lots of extras on it, and there's some really cool things about this figure, and also some that not so happy. So look, it's a good figure. That's a straight kind of immediate thing. I think you can probably tell from the figure the look and feel of it. And the packaging, it is a solid figure, but there's definitely some issues about it. However, let's get a look at the packaging first and foremost. Once you open up the figure, you get a nice little G.I. Joe Cobra little baggies inside with some of the accessories on the figure. I should do one of those AMSR videos. You get the point. Inside the box is some nice pieces, but let's look at the packaging first and foremost. So you'll see that we've got both a gun and a clip, spear gun, we've got a knife, we've got the goggles and the backpack itself, or the oxygen tanks, and two flippers. All of them are removable, but I've just put them on the figure for you to see them there. But all of those come apart. So literally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, really 7 accessories, which is pretty impressive. We get some nice artwork on the figure, which sadly, because of this new packaging, is on this side, but it's just a little bit different now than the other packaging, so I don't know whether it's really going to fit in too well, but yeah. Anyway, number 73 in the line, and we get a close-up of the artwork down the side of the box. Up at the top, G.I. Joe Classified Series, not much else to tell you there. This is, as we see, this plastic-free packaging. It's going to change, I think, so for G.I. Joe as well as others. We know it's happening with Star Wars and Marvel Legends. So what is interesting is the box has embossing on it, which is a kind of first, and now will be a last, because we won't see this kind of packaging. But it's got incredibly nice, shiny, glossy kind of digital renders and artwork there. There is a kind of story about these kind of Loch Ness monster-like pieces. I don't ask me to explain it here. Go Google it. G.I. Joe Snake Monsters Torpedo, and you'll kind of get the answer. QR code if you want to scan more and find out more about this figure on the G.I. Joe website. All of these little codes reveal some features about the individual kind of skills of the person. And this kind of denotes he's a good guy. So yeah, there you go. So what else we got on the back? You can see, yep, 6 inches, 157 millimeters, or 15 centimeters, and some other kind of features and parts and pieces on them there. Which nice little touch is the forearm gauntlet piece. On the bottom is the UPC, should you need this. I don't think anyone's going to have any trouble finding this figure, unlike the others that were released around this time. This one has been pretty generously available around the world. The first thing, just before we get into the figure, that I'm going to pick up a small negative on it. Small negative is the suit is very white in the digital render. Real white, real black. But to be fair, the original 1983 release, it was kind of grey. So there's a bit of a reference material there, referencing back. It wasn't a pure white way back in the day. It was grey. But the digital render looks really crisp and white. And it's white, man. That is white. It's not so white on the figure. It comes in as a kind of grey, and we'll look at that in just a minute. But two other things that are nice in the packaging. One is when he arrives, he comes in this tray, which is rather cool, and it's got a print of the figure inside, which is a nice little touch to the packaging. Again, we're now going to lose that again, so it feels like a bit of a wasted journey. Also inside is this cool little cardboard kind of case, and it's just looks great. It looks really nice, and that stores all your Joe bits and bobs in it, and it's a nice little piece for a diorama if you wanted it or something like that to go in the background. It's pretty cool, and it's kind of like a torpedo locker. It's the locker of all his parts and pieces. It's just a cardboard box, as you can see inside, but all that stuff is wrapped up in the little paper baggie, and yeah, it's kind of nice. And that together makes up the inside of the box itself, the packaging I just showed you. Okay, very thorough job on the packaging. Let's get on with the figure. First and foremost, let's look at his accessories and zoom in on that weapon because it's pretty cool. I don't recall seeing this before. I'm sure maybe some other Joe has had this, but I don't recall this weapon being used on someone else before. Probably has. Inside is the little removable clip, as we mentioned, which slots in. And that is pretty much that weapon. There's that little forearm gauntlet. Looks great, like a little radar going on his wrist there. That's beautiful, that little touch. What it does have is at the front, little blast effect holes, so you can add your G.I. Joe blast effects. I think those from Marvel Legends work as well. In the other arm, I have placed the spear gun. It's a little bit bent from the packaging, but what we do get is a kind of arm shoulder holster. I believe that can wrap around, or the leg or something. It can go around the figure's arm. I have not tried it yet, but I believe that's the point of that, is to, you know, put that over the forearm. I should have done that, actually. Let me do that as we speak. So if I take this off and then I put it over the arm, there we go. I guess that's the correct way of doing that. I should have got that right. Yep. I'm going to be faffing around here for ages. You get the point. Trigger finger, in we go. So, back on with the weapon. You will see some nice details, all done in black plastic. Spear gun again, it's just a little warped out packaging. And the way it's kind of done is it's got all the rope kind of materials, if it's pretending to be all caught up there. And of course that'll spiral into somebody. Lovely. So, the other weapon that he's got is his knife. Doing a Crocodile Dundee here. That's not a knife. Little rinky-dinky knife with a serrated edge. Fits quite nicely and snugly. And the flippers are the other, one of the other accessories. Done in the red and the black little slip-on shoe. And they're kind of cool, nice and simple to put on and put off. You just slide them over the shoe, there's no hassles involved. I believe there was a way Lenny showed at one point where you can't, yeah. I think, was that it? I think there's a way to hang these on. Oops, let me pull out. There's a way to add your accessories on here. So I think what he's got is you can plug in your spear gun there, I think it is, yep. And these pegs on the other side where I am not quite sure. There is a way he's done this, and it's in some of the photographs at one point where you can kind of clip stuff on. So that is how you clip in your spear gun underneath there, and that can store on the figure. But you can also, I can't remember how this worked. I don't know, maybe that's not the ideal way that it would work, but either way, I'm sure you can manage to get these on. What you could do is on the back of these, you could, not that you would, but you could put that through there and have your, something like that anyway. I'll let you play around. The point is you can probably hook these onto something, because Lenny and Emily from the Hasbro team always manage to find a way to have some kind of way to clip things onto the figure. So something like that, I'm sure there'll be a way to do it. So backpack is the other one we want to get a look at. He does have a little side pouch here, but there's no weapon or anything on there. But it's, you know, it's one of those kind of things, ammo packs or something like that. The mask itself fits incredibly snugly on the figure.
And let's get a look at that. Lots of nice detail on the mouthpiece. It is not removable, the mouthpiece itself, but the mask sits over the figure. And once you get it right, it's got the full kind of black surrounding all over the entire figure. But it is very simple and easy to remove. Just slides over. So you can kind of, with a little bit of faffing around, have it posed on his head, kind of. Not really, but you get the point. You could have it down like so, or just take the damn thing off. So whatever you want to do, and there is Edward Torpedo underneath. Obviously a dark-skinned gentleman with that name. But it's really cool. Very cool facial sculpt indeed. think they've managed to capture a nice, unique duo there, and it looks fab. Little ears coming through on the mask design. But it looks really good. It's a little bit of paint spill there, but it's not a showstopper. So yeah, very impressive figure. The backpack unplugs. And on the back, it's molded and sculpted to fit very nicely. And those peg holes for the oxygen on the tank. Again, that little clip for weapons. So it's nicely done. There's no, I thought there might be a reference to the original 1983 version with the orange tanks, but there's nothing there that's orange. So not a showstopper again
for Hasbro. So that's just covered all the accessories on the figure. This is the key thing I was going to talk about, is the plastic. It's kind of like some Star Wars Black Series figures, where the white clone troopers just are not white. So again, the design is very, very white. And the result is very, very grey. Yeah. So the whole figure seems to have been cast in this grey. And then have black paint added on top of that. The arms are separately done black. Now that might be because casting it all in pure white and then putting black paint over the top of it would be probably engineering-wise a little harder. I don't think it's going to work very well the way that perhaps the digital render intends. But it's a shame that what is on the packaging is not quite what you get. That said, it still does match the original kind of 1983 design, so the grey is there. And all over, it's a solid figure. There's not a great deal wrong with it. Paint is a little bit sloppy on some parts up at the top of the figure. Belt and so forth, and we just made around the mask. It's a little hit and miss, but it's not bad. I've seen a lot worse figures from a lot other manufacturers, so I really wouldn't complain about it too much. But paint-wise, yeah, it's not too bad. It's pretty tight. There are some marks here and there, but relatively solid. But I have seen better on Joe's, so... but there you go.
So in terms of articulation on this figure, you've got a ball joint on the head, and then on the neck it has a ball joint there too. So you've got lots of flexibility and range of movement on both the head and the neck. As you would expect, it's got a butterfly joint and a ball joint on the shoulder. It's got a bicep swivel. You get double joint at the elbows. It is pinless tech. It is down to a swivel on the wrist and both back and forth. We've also got a very solid ab crunch, very deep indeed, and very much all the way back. We've got a swivel on the waist. And up at the top of the legs, pin, then a thigh swivel, double joint to the knees, again, pinless, and down to, a rocking ankle, which is not a rocking ankle, and then a rocking foot. Rocking indeed. So lots of articulation on them, lots of weapons, lots of accessories. G.I. Joe's killing it. It's a great line. It's not without its flaws, and it's certainly not a perfect figure, but by all accounts, it's a pretty damn solid one. So if only Hasbro did this with Star Wars and Marvel Legends and added all these extras in, if they could. But it's all down to licensing and money. But there we go. Solid figure. I hope this gives you a good overview of Edward Torpedo Le Lola, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, and it helps you decide whether you want the figure or not. But it's a solid one. Another solid Joe. We'll see for more reviews coming up soon.